I can confidently tell you I am certain those previous sequences aroused a plethora of emotions within you. Or at the very least incited a reaction, elicited a response from you, the viewer, as the segments unfolded their narrative, choreography, staging, direction. Building upon the encapsulating medium's strengths, managing to leave a lasting imprint on your mind. Even now, as you're listening to me singing praises to the value of these works of art, and surely even long after you've finished watching this video, when randomly, a certain landmark moment, pivotal point, will resurface in your thoughts, allowing you to relive that same rush of emotions as when watching it for the first time. But besides the conscious level of assimilating such a sequence on a much deeper scale, there was something more to the experience, wasn't it? Something that may initially not even seem palpable, something more akin to a vibe, an emotion, rather than a classic succession of frames. Thinking back on it, you may not even remember what it looked like, only that it greatly exacerbated the feelings you were having while watching the clips, leaving an everlasting impact on your viewing experience. The often unsung heroes of this medium, impact frames, are something I've always taken an interest in, and to better my understanding of them while involving my other interest, programming, I decided to try my hand at creating impact frames programmatically, as well as automatically finding the best locations to insert them. Also, I really want to put accent on the try part, because under no circumstances am I considering something created in this manner comparable to the hard work, talent, and dedication of artists creating these works of art that bring boundless enjoyment. But without further ado, let's get started with this whole new exciting project. This time, when outlining the structure of the project and the video as well, I realized how simply studying the subject matter was a valuable and considerable component needing to be showcased. I began by trying to find some guidebooks, rules, suggestions on impact frames, and what I pretty much discovered was that there was no such thing, at least not available in a centralized manner. You just simply have to go by feeling, what seems to best evoke the emotion you're trying to instill in your audience. And I can't even argue with that. You can't reduce and constrain such a dynamic technique to several do's and don'ts. But the problem here is that I kinda have to do that for, you know, the whole premise of the video. So I moved on to trying to come up with an algorithm by studying various clips, demos, showcases, going frame by frame, trying to maybe find some similarities, maybe some key points, or maybe some common ordering. I can't say it was very successful, as there are as many styles as there are artists, but I could at least draw some conclusions. First, sketches are really cool, like really, really cool. Going from the classic animation style to a rough pencil drawing where outlines blur, blend together, then are contrasted by wild strokes to imprint extreme dynamism, is something I'll never get tired of seeing. Secondly, flashing between a frame and its negative will accentuate it even further. I can't really explain this one, just that it makes the chemicals in my brain go monkey mode. And thirdly, impact frames don't need to be simply black and white, or even grey, just to differentiate them from the rest of the frames. You can play around with color, shapes, just make them memorable. Seeing an image reduced to more basic shapes, but with a much higher contrast to accentuate their value as focal points, or maybe trying some watercolor dissolving effect, where it may seem for a moment that all blends together into one, is something that will more often than not elevate such a sequence. With this knowledge, I figured my standardized impact frame sequence would be as follows. A sketch with a light background and dark strokes, an inverted sketch with a dark background and light strokes, a black and white frame with a light background and dark outlines, a transition frame from black and white, black becoming a darker gray while the white becomes a lighter gray, a watercolor frame which has increased saturation, an inverted transition frame, an inverted black and white frame, an inverted sketch, and finally a sketch. I found this to be the most satisfying and cohesive progression of frames that seems to blend well with most clips, to the extent of my knowledge and tested videos. And now, time to implement this bad boy. First, the sketch effect was obtained by converting the input frame to grayscale, followed by applying a Gaussian blur to reduce noise and improve contour detection. Then use Kenny edge detection to find edges, this edge detection operator being widely used in various computer vision tasks, such as object recognition, image segmentation, and feature extraction, offering qualitative and reliable detection, consolidating its popularity. Next, based on these edges, I could find contours upon which I would be drawing those pencil strokes. I opted for these strokes to be perpendicular to their respective contours, contours, as opposed to relative to a focal point, as that didn't work on most frames, and my intention is an algorithm that works on all inputs, at the cost of a more generic look. Also, to give the impression of varying pressure levels, as well as pencil tips and material, I provided some randomization to the strokes' color, width, and length. Next, the inverted sketch was done by simply doing a bitwise knot on the sketch frame. Yeah, that's it. For the black and white frame, I used most of the same process as with the sketch frame, except that I stopped at the selection of contours, which I directly drew upon the fully white base image. This offered a nice counterbalance to the messy style of the sketching technique. Like the previous example, the inverted black and white frame was obtained by applying a bitwise knot on the base frame. Also, something that was a bit of a head-scratcher for me and gave me quite a bit of trouble, which you'll notice when progressing through the iterations, is that the binary images didn't have all three channels, aka red, blue, and green by default, just one for the binary value of black or white, which meant the frames wouldn't be used when writing the video. Of course, without warning, because why would I possibly want that? So, for the frames to be usable, I had to explicitly convert a binary image to an RGB image that was still binary in color. Yeah. For the intermediate frames, I took each of the black and white and its inverted counterpart, created two masks, based on their white and black pixels, as they are simply binary images, then applied the desired shade of gray to the black mask, respectively light gray to the white mask. Finally, I added a bit of blur to convey a stroke of dynamism. Call it a stylistic choice, if you may. Last but not least, because it literally goes in the middle, the watercolor frame is obtained by first converting the initial frame to grayscale, then a bilateral filter is applied to smooth out the image while preserving edges and, in parallel, a median filter to enhance details. Next, an adapted threshold is used to obtain the edges, which are converted back to a BGR image, finally combined with the original image using a bitwise end. And to make it pop a bit more, I also increase saturation of the watercolor frame by converting it to HSV, modifying the corresponding property, then converting it back to BGR. Now, by placing them in the specified order, the mechanism for creating an impact frame sequence was done. What follows is creating a system for managing the videos. I wanted to be able to read a video from a specified path, get the frame from a video at a specified index, to help with the generative mechanism, and finally be able to write to a video file. For the last part, I had it designed so that the user would provide a list of impact frames and the indices at which they would be placed, in the form of a list of tuples. With this, I could, for the first time, insert impact frames into a random video at a desired moment. I simply had to loop through the video and decide which frame I wanted to have as the basis, this sequence being the result of that. But going frame by frame and choosing yourself when to insert these frames is way too much effort, right? Therefore, the final piece of the puzzle was destined to be a tool that would automatically find the best moments to insert these frames in. More specifically, I wanted to detect the most dynamic sequences and pick the frames that marked their starting points, to serve as basis for my tiny little experiment here. And because I don't want to oversaturate the clip with too many impact frames, diluting the value of each, I also wanted to pick only the top 3 most dynamic sequences. Firstly, to find these dynamic segments, I iterated over all the frames in the video, using a queue to represent the current sequence, which would be processed once its length reached a desired value. This queue contains the total amount of differences, represented as a percentage between subsequent frames. When the queue's length reached the desired value, I would average these values, check if the result was above a certain threshold, and append the segment to the list of dynamic segments if true, or discard the last value in the queue and repeat the process with the next frame. But you may be wondering why I would take all these extra steps to work with a queue representing multiple frames, instead of comparing the current frame with the previous. And the answer is simple: scene change. If there is a scene change, a camera cut, maybe it moves back a couple of meters, then the difference would be enormous between the two frames, without there actually being any dynamism, a false positive, something I certainly don't want. And after this processing, I had a lot of sequences of length equal to that of the queue, representing subsequences of a larger, continuous and dynamic segment. So, to group these together and only work with those larger segments, I used Union Find. Then took these segments, sorted them by the average percentage in difference between frames, then took the top 3 of those, or less if not enough were available. And by tying all these parts together, I could now simply input the path to a video file and have the program do its magic. And it kinda works? Okay, but after tweaking the parameters a bit more and fixing that problem with the binary frames, I ran it again and this time... Well, not to pat myself on the back too much, but I think it turned out rather decent, don't you think? At least if you have less of a trained eye. But you know, looking at this and thinking about it a bit, an idea hit me. Sure, impact frames are generally used in animation. I can't even think of a live-action show making use of them. But my program doesn't really care if the source is a drawing or a real-life photo, as long as it can process it. So, I should be able to run this on any kind of video, right? Okay, maybe not on that, right now. But what about... Yeah, maybe I shouldn't get ahead of myself.